Hey everyone, I just learned something fantastic, and it is on the topic of fight or flight. So we know our autonomic nervous system can go into, my hair looks so crazy, can go into fight or flight or rest and digest, and that controls how our body functions, our heart rate, blood pressure, breath rate, all kinds of stuff. And you can consciously override that with your breath. If you breathe, if you hyperventilate, hold your breath or breathe quick or shallow, it'll communicate to your nervous system like, holy cow, we're not safe right now. We're not, you know. Or you can consciously breathe really slow and deep and communicate to your nervous system, we're safe right now, because that's what happens naturally. If there's a predator or danger around, the breath changes. And if you're somewhere safe and peaceful, the breath gets deeper. So that's one way you can impact it. Another way is your body position. If you go into a hunched, head down position, you can communicate to your body of like, we're not safe right now. We're like in like defensive protection mode. Or you can go into a power posture, put your arms over your head and open the chest, and it communicates the nervous system like, cool, we're in a place where we're safe, we can be empowered, we're stable. So here's another thing that I had not ever thought of. Got it from a neuroscientist. I'll link information below in a really cool podcast if you want to listen to it. Our vision. Our vision is a really great way to impact the nervous system. When we get stressed, our vision narrows and you get real focused on something like a small area, just focusing so hard, and the body kind of follows and our breath follows. And if you can broaden the vision, it'll help downregulate the nervous system. So you can do this at any time, broaden the vision and become aware of the periphery. And I like the idea of even holding both hands out to either side and wiggle your fingers and become aware, like see your fingers, become aware of your fingers and your peripheral vision. And when you do that, when you broaden the vision, it instantly starts changing your body and also opens up the body and the posture. Oh, it opens up the breath. It does start to instantly downregulate the nervous system and help move you into a more peaceful place. Even just doing right now after acting out, pretending to be in like hyper-focused stress mode, I'm feeling a big difference right now and it feels amazing. So this makes a lot of sense. I've experienced this with several things. In yoga, there's often the phrase of soften your vision. So instead of like hyper-focused, just soften the vision. Also in meditation, it happens naturally. A great tool to use if you're having anxiety or an intense emotion is become aware of your feet. What are your feet doing? Where are they? What's touching their skin? What position are they in? And that instantly moves your awareness broader than just this real small tight area that you're focusing on. Oh, the anxious feeling, the tightness in my stomach. And if you can broaden the awareness to somewhere else, something else at all, it'll start to open and calm things down. And so I love this. I wanted to share it with everybody. This is so cool. You can use this at any time. Broaden the perspective and open the vision to become aware of all of your peripheral vision, or in your mind's eye, or energetically, you can even become aware of not only all the space in front of you out to your peripheral vision, but behind you as well. You can kind of imagine seeing what's in front of you, seeing the peripheral vision, and then just being aware in your mind's eye, seeing what's all the way around you. And it totally opens you up and takes you into a much more expansive awareness state where the body feels awesome. So have fun with that. Isn't that awesome? I love it. Okay, so I'll share some comments below if you want to look into that more and learn more about what that neuroscientist had to say.